I'm up here to talk about airway clearance. I had the opportunity to meet with quite a few of you these past couple of days and go over a few things. So feel free to just kind of jump in if you have any questions. So airway clearance, improving quality of life. So let's talk about some of the devices that are out there. I know that you, let me see here. Sorry about that. Oops, did I do something wrong here? I think I might've did something because I always do. Okay. Okay, so you had the opportunity to listen to a great many speakers, and I'm sure a lot of you are up to par on this bronchiectasis and what's going on and what we all need to do to help with airway clearance. So I just put together just a PowerPoint to help everybody become more aware of the devices that are out there. I know we're running a little short on time, but hopefully we were able to speak out in the hall and I was able to show you some of the devices. So here's just a few of the triggers, and I thought I'd go ahead and put some of those out there that may cause some constrictions or some inflammatory processes and so forth. Pulmonary hygiene is your foundation for therapy, and that's what we're going to talk about today as far as the best therapies and acapellas, airway clearance. So non-tuberculosis, mycobacteria, bronchiectasis, cystic fibrosis, and asthma seems to a lot of the patients that are diagnosed with some of these conditions, airway clearance truly, truly helps with that. The most commonly asked questions that we see in our department, which device is available for the patient? And a lot of that stems around insurance. And I know that insurance could be very difficult, but we seem to be able to kind of work around that. We've kind of built this kind of program so where we can kind of talk to our vendors and they can help us through the process. So if you have any trouble getting devices, we generally can help you with that. And what can we do to expedite insurance coverage? My big thing is once the prescription is put out there by your physician, and then it comes to us and we send it off to the company, we just ask that you do not try to contact the insurance company yourself. That just kind of holds up the process. Which company do you use as far as DME? I would highly recommend that you speak to your pulmonologist or your RT, because they would be pretty much the expert in giving you really good device or advice about which area to go to. Methods that you could use or that are out there for you. And if you haven't already noticed, we highly stress the importance of pulmonary hygiene and airway clearance. So they are available out there. You just need to kind of dig a little deep or just reach out to your pulmonologist or RT. You have your OPAP device, which is an aerobica. And there's also acapellas out there. Those devices are used to create a positive pressure when you blow into the device and also create percussion to help go down and just kind of break up and move things around for you. There's high frequency chest wall oscillation, which is your vest. And I have pictures on here so you can kind of go through those also. The Valero, which is a newer product, that one's a little bit more difficult to get cover through your insurance. It takes a little bit. So sometimes some Medicare plans do not cover it. So that's one thing. But I would just say don't get discouraged and just keep moving through the devices that are available for you. And then of course CPT. And the reason why we need airway clearance, obviously, is to clear a lot of that mucus that seems to build up and gets trapped in those airways that are either constricted or collapsed. And so the devices that are available for you, they definitely help to open up those airways and get stuff moving. So I'm just going to go ahead and just kind of go through all these pictures and devices that are available. The first one is the aerobica with your manometer. There are devices out there as far as flutter. If you do get a physician that orders an aerobica for you, I would ask that you ask for the manometer. If you just ask for the aerobica, that's all you're going to get, but you won't get the little guy down the side. And that really helps to regulate the airflow or help you make sure that you're not blowing too hard. So make sure you ask for the aerobica with the manometer. The acapella is another device out there that you may have seen. There is a difference between the blue and green if you didn't already know that. The blue one we generally will use for pediatric patients or patients with low lung volumes. It's a little bit easier to use versus the green. And then off to the side of that, if you see it on the right side, there is a little dial that will help you regulate the resistance that you're blowing against. So we also use inhaled saline nebs with our patients. It all depends. There's 0.9%, there's 3%, 7%, and 10% that sometimes we use with our patients that have a difficult time getting any secretions up. But that is widely used. If you do not tolerate one level, we generally will drop down. If you're diagnosed with any type of an asthma or even an ILD, we do start low. And I think that goes back to that question, do I need albuterol or not? And of course that would be indiscretion or up to your physician whether you need it or not. But the saline nebs are really good. And we do attach them with the aerobica, which you can not only save time, but it's like a dual therapy when you use them together. So as far as your equipment, when you're using them on a daily basis, we do want you to keep them clean and sterilized. You can do a daily clean. We do recommend that you use a distilled water if you can. You can also boil the water just let it cool down before you use it, but it would be a daily wash. You would wash it at the end of the day and make sure you open it up just to air dry overnight. And I would also open it up to the air in between use during the day. The sterilization process is, we have it there. You can use boiling water from 5 to 10 minutes. There are some support groups out there that recommend or that say 10 minutes is what is needed. Tell the patients you can use 5 to 10 minutes to boil. The 5 minutes also came from the manufacturer through studies that it's okay. But of course, I'll say 5 to 10 minutes because the more you boil it, the more comfortable you'll be with that, making sure that the sterilization gets to that NTM. You can also use a microwave steam bag, which is like a baby bottle steam sterilizer for the microwave. Be very careful with those. We have had some patients melt their devices because of the difference in the power of the microwave. You can also use alcohol and hydrogen peroxide. You do have to discard once you sterilize that and use fresh on the next one. Sterilization for your equipment is recommended. You can use it on a daily basis. These products will withstand that. And then the acapella, it's a little harder. I don't know if anybody is using the acapella PEP device right now. It's a little harder to clean and sterilize, but this is one way that you can do that with the alcohol and peroxide. You do not want to boil it. We're going to go ahead and go through this. There is your your Aero Eclipse is your nebulizer cup that we use for the patients. This one is easier to attach to the aerobica. You can also use it with all either albuterol, salines, antibiotics. It is FDA approved for all those medications. And then we're going to go through these. Here's your vest therapies. I'm just going to give you what is available out there. You have a Hillrom, which is the vest. Respirtech is Encourage. Electromed is the smart vest. Those are your air percussion vests. You are attached to a machine with some hoses, but it does work quite well. We do recommend those. You do have also some battery powered ones, which is your portables, which would be the Monarch and the Afflow. Some patients will go that route if they want to be able to be more mobile and walk around. It's a little hard. The devices are a little heavier, but that would be up to you. So what I'm going to give you here is when the device is ordered, it's going to be either shipped to your home or it's going to be brought to your home by a trainer. They'll bring it, they'll set it up, and I put on there which companies will do that. And then here's some pictures of exactly what the device and the garments look like. I did have some devices set out in the hall, and I hope you were able to look at those. So this one is your Hillrom device. We have your Encourage device. All these garments that I'm showing you are machine washable, including in the smart vest. This device right here is the Monarch. It's a little heavier, but it does use pods to create that percussion. And you can isolate the pods. If you're sensitive in one area, you can also isolate those. And then you have the Afflow vest, also run by a battery. And this is one of the newer devices called the Valera. It is actually a lung expansion, so it does have that positive pressure. It has oscillation and it has a nebulizer, all three attached in one. And it is a favorite of most patients, but this one is a little bit more difficult to get insurance to pay for. And then of course, the benefits of your pulmonary hygiene is the mobilization and removal of secretions to decrease recurrent lung infections, antibiotic use, hospitalization, and it does decrease that cough. Sometimes we have a very persistent cough, but using your airway clearance devices seems to help with that. Here's my disclaimer of where I am employed outside of National Jewish would be Electromed, Hillrom, and Respirtech. I do home setups on all different devices. And that would be it. Yes. We do not. And one of the reasons is I don't have any case studies to prove that is effective. So I go through the recommendations of the manufacturer. Yes. Oh, sure. I'm sorry. Does anybody else have any questions? Well, thank you so much.